In the 3rd century BCE, Megasthenes, an ancient Greek historian and diplomat, served as an ambassador for Seleucus Nicator, a successor of Alexander the Great, to the court of Chandragupta Maurya, the founder of the Maurya Empire in ancient India. Megasthenes' extensive writings on his travels and observations in India offer valuable insights into the culture, society, and governance of the time. His work, known as the Indika, stands as one of the most significant sources of information about ancient India. Megasthenes was born in Seleucia on the Tigris River. He was the son of a nobleman and was educated in philosophy, literature, and politics. Some Western historians claim that Megasthenes met Porus, which implies that he might have been present during Alexander the Great's invasion of India. However, these accounts do not specifically state that Megasthenes served as a soldier. After Alexander's death, Megasthenes entered the service of Seleucus Nicator, one of Alexander's generals and the founder of the Seleucid Empire. In around 302 BC, Seleucus sent Megasthenes to India as an ambassador to the court of Chandragupta Maurya, the founder of the Mauryan Empire. After a long journey from Greece, he arrived in India. Although the specific mode of transportation used during that era is not explicitly documented, it is probable that he traveled by land and sea routes, which were commonly used for long distances in ancient times. He appears to have passed through the Punjab region in northwestern India, providing detailed information about the rivers there. Subsequently, he likely traveled along the Jamuna and Ganga rivers to Pataliputra, present-day Patna, the capital of the Mauryan Empire. This journey suggests a combination of overland travel and river voyages. Megasthenes spent several years in India, during which time he traveled extensively and gathered information about the country and its people. He visited the major Indian cities of Taxila, Ujjain, and Mathura. He also mentioned visiting the Bay of Bengal. He was a keen observer of Indian society and culture, and his accounts provide valuable insights into life in India during the Mauryan period. He describes the political system, the economy, the social structure, and the religious beliefs of the Indians. He also provides detailed descriptions of Indian cities, temples, and palaces. During his time in India, Megasthenes resided at the Mauryan court for several years, where he had the opportunity to observe and interact with people from different walks of life. He traveled extensively throughout the empire, visiting cities, towns, and rural areas, and documenting his observations. Megasthenes' book, Indika, is a valuable source of information about India in the 4th and 3rd centuries BC. It is one of the earliest Western accounts of India, and it provides a wealth of information about the country's history, geography, and culture. Indika is divided into 4 books. The first book deals with the geography of India and its people. The second book describes the political system and the army of the Mauryan Empire. The third book deals with the economy, the social structure, and the religious beliefs of the Indians. The fourth book is a collection of miscellaneous information about India, including its animals, plants, and minerals. Indika is a valuable resource for historians and scholars of Indian history and culture. It provides a unique glimpse into life in India during the Mauryan period, and it has helped to shape our understanding of ancient India. Legend has it that during his travels, Megasthenes beheld the majestic Garuda, a mythical bird revered as a symbol of power and protection in Indian mythology. Megasthenes' work Indika contains several fascinating and unusual descriptions of India during his time. He describes a tribe of Indians with 8 toes and feet pointing backwards. He also mentions people who have no noses. There are accounts of individuals with snake-like legs. A 5th century Greek historian Herodotus documented the conflict between Greece and Persia. He has also written about India in his writing. He mentions about the gold-digging ants in India. Megasthenes repeats Herodotus' story about India having gold-digging ants. Megasthenes tells us about the Ostomi tribes in his book Indika, who live near the origins of the Ganges, have no mouth, cover their bodies, which are all overly hairy, and only live by breathing. They do not eat any kind of food or drink. Please note that these accounts are based on Megasthenes' observations and interpretations, and some of them may not be accurate or may have been misunderstood or misinterpreted. The Indika is a historical document, and some of its content should be understood in the context of the time it was written. The original manuscript of the book Indika, unfortunately, has not survived. Despite this, its content has been referenced by numerous contemporary and later historians. Megasthenes' writings provide a valuable window into the ancient world of India, offering unique insights into the culture, society, and governance of the Mauryan Empire. His legacy endures as a testament to his curiosity, intellectual rigor, and enduring fascination with the wonders of India. Similar to Megasthenes, we at Journey Through Time are embarking on a timeless odyssey that traverses our past, present, and envisioned future. Join us on this extraordinary voyage through time, where the past meets the present, and history's echoes align with the rhythm of our own existence.